Today's topic is projections of straight lines, particularly the second case. Okay. The case is straight line perpendicular to one plane and parallel to another. This is the case, and in that case we can have two different variants. The first variant is straight line perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. The second variant is straight line perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP. So these two are the variants today we are going to discuss. One by one we can see. The first one, along with an example problem, we can do. The problem is a straight line, maybe the name AB, is 30 mm long is perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. The end A is 10 mm above HP and 20 mm in front of VP. Draw its projections. This is what the problem. A straight line, its name is AB. It is of the length 70 mm, is perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. Okay, this is the overview of the environment. In depth, the location of the straight line with respect to the horizontal plane and vertical plane are also given in the problem. So with respect to the one end of the straight line, see here, so consider this is our straight line. That straight line is going to be parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. So how to make it? So consider this is the board is what your vertical plane and the floor is the horizontal plane. The condition is your straight line should be perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. How to make it? Now what is the condition of the straight line? Now the straight line is parallel to VP and HP. It's parallel to both HP and VP. How to what is the current condition with respect to the problem? The straight line is perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. Perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. This is what the condition given in the problem for the straight line AB. The end A is 10 mm above HP and 20 mm in front of VP. By this data, what you can understand? See, this is nothing but the end A. The end A. And that's the end B. A, B. The end A is 10 mm above HP. Consider it is your horizontal plane. So the straight line's one end A is 10 mm above HP and the same end is 20 mm in front of VP. In front of VP. So its angularity relation between HP and VP is primary. The secondary information is in where exactly the straight line is located with respect to the horizontal plane and vertical plane. So this is nothing but one end A is 10 mm above HP and 20 mm in front of VP. If the end A, one logical question to you, if the end A is 20 mm in front of VP, how much the end is in front of VP? If this line is parallel to a VP? Okay. If the end A is 20 mm in front of VP and the line is parallel to VP. And what is the distance between the end B and the vertical plane? The same 20 mm and the same 20 mm. Now, one more question. The end A is 10 mm above HP. Above HP. So what is the distance between the end B and the horizontal plane? This 10 mm span as well as the total length of the line is 70 mm. So the end B will be at the range 80 mm from the horizontal plane. So these things you have to be understand based on your normal intelligence. Okay, it's not a technical one. See here. So this is what the condition of the straight line with respect to the horizontal plane, vertical plane. The line, this is your vertical plane and that's your horizontal plane. The line is perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. And this is what your end A. And that's what your end B. So if you consider it's in a 3D environment. See, in this way, your straight line is floating in air. The end A is 10 mm above the horizontal plane. And the same time, the same end A is 20 mm in front of the vertical plane. The line is in the first quadrant, no doubt. Okay, above HP, in front of EP, first quadrant. And this is what your end B. Now, your objective is to draw the front and the top views of this straight line. First, you need to draw the XY line. Thereafter, we can think how to get the front and top views. XY. Now I am having only the XY line. Now, before getting to the answer, just have a rough look on how the answer will be look like. So in that case, if your straight line is being like that, you are seeing it from the front in order to have its front view in the vertical plane. So your visual rays are passing in this way. So the which you can get in the vertical plane screen, you will get a line. You will get a line in the vertical plane screen. That line is nothing but your front view. This is nothing but your front view. Front view. And what you will get as top view when you look the same line from the top? You will get a point only. You will get a point only. So this is nothing but similar to the case which we discussed in the very first class. If a cylinder is looking from the front view, you will get a rectangle as a front view. If the same cylinder, if you look from the top, you will get a circle as a top view. So here also, your straight line is like that. It's like that. It's having only one dimension length. There is no diameter for straight line. Okay, there is no diameter for a straight line. So the straight line is having only one dimension, it is length. If the straight line is standing like that, if you want to see it from the front, in the vertical plane, you will get a line. If you see it from the top, you will get a point. That is a dot only obtained as a top view. So this is what the characters of the projections when the line is perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. So just draw what you obtain. Okay. So here, this is nothing but your top view. And that's nothing but your front view. The same we are going to draw here. Along with the distances given in the problem with respect to the horizontal plane and vertical plane for the straight line. So here, this is your top view. This will be looking like a point. Where this the point will be located? This point will be located as usual, 20 mm in front of the VP, because the line is 20 mm in front of the VP. Okay. And if you rotate this, the dot will be here. Come here as your top view and your front view will be like that. This is your front view and that will be your top view. These two parties will be connected with the help of a projector. Okay. This is your XY line. This is your XY line. So first you have the your XY line. Now you need to draw this front view and that top view with respect to the XY line. Not you are going to think with respect to horizontal plane or vertical plane. Now you are going to think with respect to the XY line only. Now your aim is to draw this front view. So just locate your front view. It's just like a line with respect to your XY. So where it is located first, above XY or below XY? Find it first. Thereafter, how much above XY or how much below XY you can decide. So the front view is located above XY only. Above XY only. Where? Exactly where? So in this straight line, this is what your end A. Very sorry. This is what your end A, and that's what your end B. So in the front view also, this end may be A dash, and that end will be B dash, B dash. So this is what we are going to have here also. So that A dash B dash with length 70 mm is nothing but your front view. That should be drawn above XY. How much above XY? Actually, the end A is located 10 mm above XY. So the same way, the end A dash, the front view of the straight line AB, A dash B dash, also the end A dash should be located 10 mm above the XY line. So above this XY line, you have to measure 10 mm first. So here, I need to rub something. First, you need to measure 10 mm in order to locate the end A dash in the front view. Is my writing is visible to you? If not, I will write little bigger. And have a leader line just to guide you. And I am starting to draw the straight line A dash B dash, just your front view, with the length of 70 mm. B dash. This is A dash. Okay. And one more point I want to add. So you need not to give a very big dot for the terminals. Since we are going to name them, you need not to give this much of big dot at the terminals of the straight line. Here, in order for your understanding purpose, I am little highlighting the terminals with a somewhat bigger dot. So you don't do that. So in your paper, just leave without the big dots in the terminal. Okay. So simply you can draw like that and write like that. Okay. So after marking the terminals name with alphabets, immediately you have to draw its projector. Here you can see one thing, for the end A dash and A B dash, you can need to draw only one projector, because these two terminals are purely perpendicular. The line is purely perpendicular to the XY line. So whenever you are drawing a projector from B dash and A dash, they will coincide with each other. Even on that time also, you should not increase the thickness of your projector, or you should not increase the darkness of your projector, and don't consider that it is actually responding to points. So I need to give more darkness. Don't think like that. Okay. Everywhere, whatever it may be, your projector should be very, very light and should be drawn with your 2H pencil only. Okay. Just I completed drawing the projector of the points A dash and B dash. And you need to mention the length of the line also, since it is given in the problem. The length of the straight line given in the problem is 70 mm. Okay. This will be nothing but the front view length of the line in this problem also. And I just completed the front view of the problem, and the next only step is to draw the top view. What is actually the top view here? The top view is nothing but is simply a point. A point is nothing but being a top view. And where the point is located, above XY or below XY, first you have to decide that. Thereafter, how much above XY, how much below XY. Okay, it's actually below XY, since it is top view. In the first angle projection, we are processing with first quadrant. So always your front view will be above xy and the top view will be below xy. Here also the same rule is applicable. Your top view, this dot is comes below xy, and below xy you have to draw that dot. And where exactly below xy? Just I am asking, this is nothing but your xy line, and from that xy line, how much below this dot is located? See here, it is actually in the previously rotated in this way. So there the distance between the VP screen and the dot is 20 mm. So with the same radius it is rotated. So here also the distance between the XY line and the top view is 20 mm. So first you have to make a dimension line of 20 mm for helping us to locate the point. And where to locate the top view as a dot? Here it is in the projector of A dash, B dash, and 20 mm below xy. I am marking the top view. Okay. Now the question is how to name it. Whether I need to name it with A dash or A or B. What will be the name of this dot? The name of this dot is AB, because it is representing the both terminals. When you seeing this straight line in this direction, you can separately mark the A dash in bottom end and B dash in the top end. But if you look it from the top, the both terminals are coincides with each other, and you are going to get only a dot. So how to name it? You need to represent the two terminals without any doubt. In addition, you have to differentiate these two based on their visibility. See here, when you look the line from the top, B, A, two terminals are there. The B is in the top and A is in the bottom. So among B and A, which end is visible to you? Which end you can see when you view it from the top? The end B only visible to you, and the A is an invisible end, or some way it is called as hidden end. Hidden end just falls beneath of the point B. So it is, the A is your invisible end. So here, however, we mentioned this dot as A and B, the A should be located inside a bracket in order to differentiate from B, and means that the A is an invisible end when you view it from the top. See here also you can see, if you view it from the top, the end B is visible to you, and the end A is just falls below B, and it's an hidden end or invisible end. So in order to highlight the invisible end, you have to write that end name with inside a bracket. So in this way you have to mark A and B for a single point. This is actually not a point. It is actually the top view of this straight line. Why this straight line becomes a dot? It's fact. If it is standing like that, he will look like a point. Okay. So this is what the answer to this problem. In this way, you can draw the front and top views of the straight line if the straight line is perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. And the concept, the system of projection we followed here is as same as what we followed for the projections of points. Only based on the geometrical element and the environment only the changes may happen, but there is no change in the procedure. Okay, mind it. Let me do rub off the board. In the same case, let me to work with the next case. Straight line perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP. Perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP. That is, a straight line may be standing like that. Okay, so it's your VP and the floor may be the HP. The straight line is now perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP. Parallel to HP. If a line is being like that, how to draw its front and top view? Let's see. Let me to give an example problem. A straight line CD, the name is CD, is 65 mm long . Its one end C is 20 mm above HP and 25 mm in front of V. The line is perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP. Draw its projections. This is what the problem we are going to practice now. A straight line, its name is given as CD and its length is 65 mm. Its one end C is located 20 mm above HP and 25 mm in front of VP. And the straight line by nature, it is perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP. Now you need to draw its front and top views through the first angle projection method. Right. First, let's have a rough look on the environment. Or straight line is being like that. Okay. It may be the end EC and that may be the end D and your VP screen and HP screen. Okay. The straight line is standing, floating like that. The length of the straight line is given as 65 mm and the end C is located 20 mm above HP. 20 mm above HP. And 25 mm in front of VP. That distance in front of VP is 25 mm. Maybe in the rough sketch, I am not proportionate to the dimension value. See, I am showing this as 20 and that as 25. Seems not proportional to the true dimension, but just for our rough work purpose, I am writing that. Okay, recognize that. So the end C is 20 mm above HP and 25 mm in front of VP. Now you need to project its front and top views. If you look from the front, this is nothing but the straight line. How it will look like in the front? This will look like a dot. This will look like a dot. And if you try to see it from the top, what will be its top view? You are going to get in the horizontal plane. It's nothing but a straight line. It's nothing but a straight line. Just a reciprocal of the previous problem. Okay, this will look like a straight line, and that end may be C, and this end may be D. And here you can give name as C dash comma D dash. Which one need to go inside the bracket? C dash or D dash? Which one? If you look from the front, D is near to you, so it is visible to your eyes, and C is just behind the D. So C is not visible to your eyes, it's an invisible end. So you need to give bracket just around the C dash. Okay. So this is nothing but the answer we are going to draw now. Let's do with the proper systematic approach. First ever, you need to draw the XY line. I just drawn the xy line, and whatever you can start, whether front view or the top view. So first let me to start the answer with the front view. The front view here you are going to obtain is nothing but a dot only, C dash, comma D dash, a dot only. That dot should be located here, whether above xy or below xy. Let's continue. So that dot is nothing but your front view. This dot is located above xy or below xy. First find out that. So this is nothing but your xy line. Nothing but your xy line. So this dot is going to be located above the xy. If you rotate this horizontal plane in order to get the top view, so now your top view will be like that. It rotated and obtained in the flat plane. So this is nothing but your top view. That top view is going to be below xy, and this front view is always above xy. So above xy we are going to have this front view. How much above xy? See, I am asking what is that height? What is that height? So already the end C is 20 mm above horizontal plane, and the line is parallel to HP. So automatically the end D also 20 mm above HP. And when you obtain its front view in the VP screen, again the front view will be located the same 20 mm above the XY line. So first have a dimension line with the 20 mm length. And now you need to mark the front view. And that front view should be named with alphabets C dash and D dash. Let me to rub out the problem in order to avoid some confusions. C dash and D dash. Okay, and out of C dash, D dash, which one needs to be go inside the bracket? Just we discussed. The end D is visible to you when you look it from the front, and the C is just falls behind the D, so it is an invisible letter. So you need to put bracket just around the point C dash. Okay, and immediately you need to draw the projector from C dash and D dash here. Both C and D are going to have a single projector. Okay. And now you need to draw the top view. The front view works are over. You need to draw the top view. The top view of this straight line is nothing but a line. Yes, straight line CD with the length equal to the actual length of the line. The actual length of the line given in the problem is 65 mm. So with the same 65 mm length, I am going to draw the top view. It is 65 because here also the length of the line is actual length, the true length of the line is 65 mm. So without reducing in length, I am getting it. Okay. So the 65 mm length top view should be drawn below xy. That's okay. How much below xy? So where to start that 65 mm length line? So where to locate the end C? If you know that, then rest of the thing will be happen as it is. So the end C is how much below xy? That's what we have to find first. Here, when you initially obtaining your top view in the HP screen, The end C is located 25 mm in front of the vertical plane. 25 mm in front of the vertical plane. Even after rotating this, the same 25 mm is maintained between the end C and the XY line also. Okay. So now you need to draw a 25 mm length dimension line for helping us to locate the end C in the top view area. From XY, I am measuring 25 mm length line. So due to some space constraints, the dimensions what I am using are only fact here. So in your paper, you are going to use the dimension with as it is the value. Okay, you are going to use the drafter and scale and all the correct tools. So you have to maintain the dimensions 100% correct. Then only you will get the right result. So the range of 25 mm, I am going to start to draw the line. The length of the top view is 65 mm. I just completed it. The length is 65 mm. And that end is C and this end is D. The line length is 65 mm. This is nothing but the top view of the given straight line. It is your front view C dash D dash and the top view C. So this is nothing but the answer to this problem. Okay. I think these things will be caught by you. And let me rub off the board. We just completed the second case, that is a straight line perpendicular to one plane and parallel to another plane. We just practiced the two available variants, the straight line perpendicular to HP parallel to VP and perpendicular to VP parallel to HP. We just saw two examples on these two cases. Okay. And the next one is a straight line parallel to one plane and inclined to another plane. So we can have some introduction about that case only. If time permits, we can see one example on that also. And the rest of the things will be discussed in the next class. Okay. Just we can have some introduction on that particular case. The case is straight line inclined to one plane and parallel to another plane. In this case also we can have two different variants. The first variant is straight line inclined to HP and parallel to VP, and straight line inclined to VP and parallel to HP. These two are the available cases in the third case. Okay, overall it is third case. That third case having two different variants. Now just to see how the line will be looking like. So now I am taking a line. the first one, straight line inclined to HP and parallel to VP. How to make this line inclined to HP and parallel to VP? Now it is in the very first condition. Straight line parallel to both horizontal plane and vertical plane. Okay, always here aim your board as your vertical plane and the floor where I am standing is the horizontal plane. Now I am making this line floating like that. So it is parallel to VP and parallel to HP, parallel to both HP and VP. The objective is to make it inclined to HP and parallel to VP. So without disturbing its parallelism with VP, I am making it inclined to HP. Inclined to HP. Oh, whatever may be inclination, maybe 30 degree, 1 degree to 89 degree, we can make. If it is 90 degree, you can say it is perpendicular to HP, what we discussed in the last few minutes. Now it is inclined to HP and parallel to VP. So this is nothing but the actual condition of the straight line based on the first variant. So how it will be look like? So in that, this is your HP and VP, and the straight line is going to float like that. Float like that. It is parallel to VP and inclined to HP. If you are supposed to produce its front view, what you will get in the VP screen? You are going to get a straight line. Going to get a straight line. If you are supposed to view it from the top to have its top view, what you will get in the HP screen? Again, you are going to have a straight line. Again, you are going to have a straight line. Just think like it's a shadow of that. I am having this inclined to HP and blooming a light from the front. I am getting the shadow in the board, and from blooming a light from the top, I am going to get the shadow in the floor. Okay. Both will be looking like a straight line. A question to you, is these two straight line shadows are having equal length or not? These two. It is your front view and that's your top view. Will these two parties are going to have same length or not? Definitely not. Definitely not. Okay. Which one is going to have the original length of the line? The original length of the line, maybe it's 100 mm or 200 mm, whatever it may be. Its length, the original length of the line is 100 mm. So, out of front view, top view, which one is going to have the original length? The front view. The front view. And the top view is not going to get the original length 100 mm. So, what will be the length of the top view? Whether it is above 100 mm or below 100 mm. Below 100 mm. Below 100 mm. How much? That's based on the angle of inclination. That's based on the angle of inclination. That is, see here, a fact, a natural fact. If I am having a straight line like that, now it is purely parallel to horizontal plane. When I am seeing it from the top, I am going to see a line. The line, what I am seeing from the top is nothing but the front view, sorry, top view. That top view is going to have its original length 100 mm. If I slowly started to make it inclined to the horizontal plane and I am supposing to view it from the top, for example, now I made it 10 degree inclined to the horizontal plane and I am seeing it from the top. So what will I get? A line also, but with the reduced length. With a reduced length. And again I am increasing the inclination from 10 degree to 40 degree. Now I am seeing it from the top. Here the top view will be obtained in the horizontal plane. Now also a line you will get with the same length of the line, no, reduced length. Reduced length in addition, in the 10 degree situation you will get a reduced length. in the 40 degree situation also you are going to get the reduced length, which is reduced further. In the same way, if you increase the angle degree by degree, the length obtained in the top view will be start to decrease. When you reach the peak 90 degree, the length will be zero and you are going to see a dot only. This is a natural fact. This is what happening here. In the previous case, when the line is perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP, if you see it from the front, the line will be looking like a line with original length. If you see it from the top, this will be looking like a point with zero length. Dot is having no length, breadth and depth. Dot is a dot. It's a no dimensional, zero dimensional entity. Okay. And here you are going to get a line with reduced length. How much reduced is based on the angle? It's based on the angle. And this is your top view and that's your front view. Why front view alone having original length? Why the top view is become a victim in that case? Front view is having original length. But the top view only get affected. Why? Because the front view is having true length. The line is parallel to VP. So in the very first time I instructed you, without affecting the parallelism of the line with VP, I am including angle in the with the HP. So the line is still parallel to VP. If a line is parallel to a particular plane, the view obtained that plane will show its original length. See, the line is parallel to VP. So in the VP screen, you are going to get the front view with original length. The line is not parallel to the horizontal plane. So the top view which is going to obtained in the horizontal plane will get the reduced length. The same will be applicable if you switch the inclination also. In the same, the second case, the line is going to be parallel with HP and inclined to VP. See, the line is parallel to HP and without affecting the parallelism with the horizontal plane, I am giving angle to VP. The line is inclined to VP. Now, you can justify that the line will be reducing its length only in the front view. In the top view, it's going to get the original length. Why? Because the line is parallel to HP. So in the top view, there is no loss. The line is not parallel to VP. So in the front view, it's going to lose the length. Okay. So don't worry about how much going to be reduced. That will be taken care of the projectors. How the projectors going to help you, you will see in the very soon. So this is nothing but the top view of the line and that's nothing but the front view of the line. We are going to draw the front and top views for a line which is being inclined to one plane and parallel to another plane. So these two variants can be discussed along with an example. I think today's class timing is just over. So in the next class, we can see the example problems for the two cases, straight line inclined to HP and parallel to VP and inclined to VP and parallel to HP.